Tesla builds collision center in Reno, Nevada, with area for semi-truck repair. In other words, Tesla plans to build a collision center in Reno, Nevada, with space to repair Tesla semi-trucks. This is the first known location for the Tesla semi's repair, indicating preparations for a wider market release of the truck. Tesla is preparing to ramp up the production, and wider market release is on the way. Tesla began delivering Semi in early December 2022, handing over at least 36 trucks to PepsiCo. Heavy trucks have been actively used by the company since the early days and are busy delivering goods to stores and between the two companies' sites. Like any other vehicle, Tesla Semi will eventually need maintenance, and the manufacturer has begun preparations for this. This is a very serious movement on the part of Tesla. Drive Tesla has discovered that the Tesla is preparing a dedicated location for servicing and repairing Tesla semis. It makes good sense and is about time for this, for doing this, friends. Because if you are already selling and delivering semi trucks, you need a special dedicated center to service them, to maintain them. This is a sign that Tesla is taking the ramp up of Tesla Semi production more seriously. According to Drive Tesla, the facility will be located at 1195 Corporate Boulevard, Reno, Nevada. If you guys are from the area, send me some pictures. According to the documents, the building at this address belonged to Tesla, where it had a collision center there. However, it will be demolished, apparently. The plan showed that a new 44,477 square foot building will be built in the place. The construction cost is about $4.4 million, according to the filing. The plan showed that inside the building, there will be five special booths for Tesla Semi. Three of them will be located in the center of the building next to the semi paint booth. The fourth is located on the left rear side of the building and is listed as an open bay for semi, and the fifth is adjacent to it. In addition, the building will have a double wash bay, which also includes a space for semi. There are five 17-foot to 29-foot parking spaces special for trucks and extra space for semi-truck maneuvering. That was a quote, semi-truck maneuvering. Of the equipment that will be in this collision center, there are semi-paint booth, alignment system, lift wheel, balancer, and tire change. So complete Tesla Semi maintenance and service center. Tesla has the cash to keep scaling the company. It looks like they'll continue to use those funds efficiently and continue their growth. Let's see what else is happening with Tesla. Bloomberg this morning reports that Tesla is close to sealing a preliminary deal to set up a factory in Indonesia. According to people familiar with the matter, as Elon Musk's electric vehicle pioneer looks to capitalize on Southeast Asian nations' reserves of key battery metals. I don't like to report on people familiar with the matters, but in this place, it's reporting on Bloomberg. The plant will produce as many as 1 million cars a year, the people said, in line with Tesla's ambition to have all its factories globally reach that capacity. The discussions include plans around multiple facilities in the country serving different functions across production and the supply chain, one of the people said. A deal hasn't been signed and the agreement could still fall through, said the people, asking not to be identified as the talks are confidential. Again, this is per Bloomberg report. At this Torque News YouTube channel, I have filed several reports in the past about a possible Tesla Gigafactory in Indonesia. I have also reported that Tesla may build battery cells in Indonesia because of the country's rich natural resources and local laws not allowing to export raw materials abroad. Now, Korea, Japan are interesting locations for a Tesla Gigafactory, but just not cost-efficient versus Indonesia. The others are tough due to language barriers or plagued with corruption. Malaysia missed out as the new prime minister just came on board. So Indonesia may be a very good location. Indonesia has been on my Tesla Gigafactory shortlist for about 2 years now. As I've reported on that, the country has many advantages for Tesla as a second factory in Asia and the main raw material and nickel supplier with a population of 273 million, I believe. However, I am now taking these reports with a little grain of salt, friends, because last month we reported that Tesla is on the verge of making a decision in favor of Gigafactory in Mexico, and there were a lot of supporting arguments and local reports on that. However, no news yet on more developments. Having said this, I wouldn't be surprised if Tesla announces 3 new gigafactories in the next several months in Indonesia, Mexico, and Canada. Where do you think Tesla will build its next gigafactory? Indonesia, Mexico, Canada, or elsewhere? All of them will be announced this year, or only one? Okay, now let's see what else is happening with Tesla. Chinese media reports 30,000 Tesla orders in 3 days after the price cuts. The unofficial reports indicate also high traffic at Tesla stores. The recent price reductions on all versions of the Made in China Tesla Model 3 and Tesla Model Y in China might have a very big impact on the company's sales results, because we're seeing more orders and we're also seeing more traffic on Tesla stores. According to various media reports from China, Tesla notes a significant surge in customer traffic at its stores and tons of new orders after the price reduction was announced last Friday. CNEV Post reports, following local media outlet Sina, that Tesla received 30,000 orders within 3 days of the announcement on January 6. The news is treated as unofficial input. Tesla does not comment according to the article, but we assume that it might be possible because there was such a big price cut on Friday. Another article says that customer traffic and orders in China's second and third tier cities increased sharply. According to ifeng.com, which is also via CNEV Post, a mid-level Tesla executive revealed that the company delivered more than 10,000 vehicles in China on the first day of the price cut. That's also probable considering that local sales decreased by over 40% year over year in December, and the manufacturer potentially has substantial inventory that's ready for instant delivery. I also read in media that Tesla's price cuts put a lot of pressure on BYD electric vehicles. Reportedly, during the 2 days of the weekend, more than 200 Tesla vehicles were delivered each day in Ningbo, Zhejiang province, another unofficial report says. There are too many inputs like this to ignore them. We also saw that 2 out of 3 Tesla Model Y versions in China, rear-wheel drive and long-range all-wheel drive, have a slightly longer delivery times for new orders, 2 to 5 weeks instead of 1 to 4 weeks previously, which I reported. The Tesla Model Y is vastly more popular than Tesla Model 3 in China right now, about 2.5 to 1. The other cars require 1.4 weeks of waiting. See my previous reports on that, friends. Of course, not everything is positive. Customers who bought Tesla cars in China before the end of the year are not too happy that they could have saved some money if only they waited another couple of days. On the other hand, their deals, boosted by additional incentives from the manufacturer, were not bad at the time. They agreed on that deal, and you know, at some point Tesla had to change the prices. Anyway, January might be very interesting for Tesla in China. However, we are more curious about the future of the Tesla Model 3 and the long term. We'll get some serious upgrades to more attractive, we'll see them. In 2022, Model 3 sales decreased in China compared to 2021. So we'll let you know once the more news comes on that.